This is Matthew with another quick tip from Advantage Technical Service. What we're doing today is showing you how to create a cut path from a vector file using Adobe Illustrator. Now our first step is to create a duplicate layer so we don't mess up our print information that we've already created. What we want to do is click on our layer and just drag it down to the new layer item. That'll create an exact duplicate. We can go one step further and name our layers print and name our other layer cut, which will help us distinguish even further. What we'll do is we'll close our print layer and then we'll lock it so that we don't accidentally override anything. On our cut layer, we'll select everything. And I want to create an offset path so I'm not cutting right on the edge of the image. I'd like a little bit of white space around this. So I'll go to my object menu under path and create an offset path. We'll keep it at 1.5. I like rounded edges. I just think it looks a little bit smoother on your final product. And then I'll hit OK. Now we've got a nice rounded large object around there, but if we look at it in wireframe, you can see there's a lot of objects that'll end up being cut. What we need to do is consolidate this into just one path. That's where our Pathfinder tool comes in. Now I've got it open already, but if you don't, it's under the window menu, under Pathfinder. And you'll see a window that looks like this, and we want to use the first object, which is Add to Shape Area. Click on that, and then click Expand. And now we've got one large object. Now we've got some smaller spaces in here, which for some applications we'll end up keeping, but for a decal we really want to get rid of that and just have the one cut object on the outside. So what we'll do is we'll uncompound this path, and then we've got everything selected separately. We'll click just our outside path, and to get rid of everything else we'll select the inverse, what we don't want, and delete key, and it's gone. Now we can turn that into a stroke just so we can see. Turn our print layer back on and you can see how smooth that lines up to our cut layer. Now we're ready to send this into our program of choice to print and cut. Hope this has been helpful. We'll see you next time.